Hello everyone. Today's tutorial is going to go over on how to cut out this hair in Photoshop using the channels. And so we're going to start all over here. What we're going to be looking for is a contrast between the background and the hair. Okay. And we want the most contrast. We don't really want to focus on this area here because this will all be cut away anyway. And what we'll do is we'll take this channel and we'll bring it down and create a copy of it because we don't want to mess up this one here. So we'll go ahead and once we do that, then we want to pull up the levels and adjust the levels by Control L. That'll allow us to go in here and get the most contrast out that we want. So what you want to do is you make your whites, you know, a little bit wider. We don't want too much there. And then you can just work it. Now again, remember, focus around the outside here. And you can adjust this middle one also. So you know, we're going to have to knock that out anyway. So we can pull that down there. So if you see the too much there, it'll get fuzzy and lose it some sharpness. And let's see. Because you want some of that detail. You don't want it to bake it. You want some of the lighter ones also because it's going to if you go too much, then it starts blurring out and getting, there's no detail there. So we'll bring it back a little bit. Just checking around, all around. All right. So that's good right there. So we'll say okay. And right now, looks pretty decent. So we'll go ahead and hold down the control key and go ahead and select. Now you can tell is select the outside here instead of the inside, but that's okay. We'll fix that over here. Once we create the layer mask from that selection, again, it pulled out the middle. So what we'll do is make sure you highlight that. We'll go Control I. That'll bring that back. So right now it doesn't look too bad, but we're missing part of her face. A little bit transparent. The dress is transparent right here. And her shoulder over here is transparent. So what we can do is we hold down the Alt key and click that over there. Let's get our brush and go through here. We basically want all that because let's get rid of this hardness and make it a little bit harder, a little bit smaller, so we don't mess up too much. Because basically all we care about is the ends, the details on the ends. So this came out here a little bit. We'll have to fix that a little bit, depending on and of course you can zoom in, make it a little easier. So if you make it look nice on the zoom in, it's going to look nicer when you zoom out. And also, I'm using the mouse today. Probably should have my pen set up. Get straighter lines with that. Okay. Alright, let's zoom back out. Let's go 40, because there you go. A little bit better there. And go ahead and hit Alt, click. Alright, so that doesn't look too bad. Let's go ahead and put a solid color behind it. Let's just say okay for now. And then let's put it below it so that we can actually see the picture. And let's give it another color. Let's go with maybe something that we can see. Oh, that's too much. There's blue in here. That looks good. Alright, so see how the dress came out now? So we threw that down there. Say okay. And let me show you what I'm talking about on the ends right here. See these? It looks a little bit frizzy. So we'll go 70. You'll see the different color. It actually doesn't look too awful bad, but we can clean that up. Okay, so what we'll do now is we'll add a new layer, and that goes above this layer here. And once we're there, we'll right click over on the layer side and say create clipping mask. So what we want to do is we want to set this on darken. And then we'll go over and select our clone tool. Make sure it's on darken here. And also make sure it's on current and below. So it'll do this one and the below one. Okay. And you can see on the edges here, the like a highlighted look on the curls. So what you want to do is just hit the Alt. And grab parts of the hair over here. And as you go around, you want to catch and update your tools so that it'll go ahead and do there. So you're going to definitely, you should spend more time doing this. And what I'll do is I'll speed up through here for you. So as you can see how the highlights go away around it and the hair itself gets a little darker. A little bit more clear to see. That's why it's important to update it as you go around. I'm just doing it real fast too, guys. So yes, there is a little bit of color difference from the original. But for the sake of a 20 minute video versus a 12 or 13 minute video, that's what we're gonna do. So we fix that. All right, everyone. Just make sure as you're going through, if you spend more time, it's going to look better. And just remember the settings. You can always play with the settings here with the blending mode settings. And also up here is your blending mode settings and your current blow. Always make sure that's turned on. Otherwise, it does not work as well. Okay, everyone. That concludes the tutorial. I hope everybody learned a different technique today and enjoyed it. If you liked it, go ahead and like it for me. And if you want to see more, go ahead and subscribe. All right. Thank you.